Hey Park Explorers, my name is Tyler Bird and I'm an AmeriCorps member serving with the Florida Conservation Corps, and we want to welcome you to the Museum in the Parks program.
And I'm Ranger Julianne, and we're really excited to share with you one of the coolest places in Florida, Paynes Prairie Preserve State Park.
Established in 1970, Paynes Prairie Preserve State Park is one of the best places in Florida to see our native wildlife. Alligators, limpkins, herons, and all sorts of creatures big and small call the prairie home. Our park is also a paradise for many kinds of plants, from towering oak trees to beautiful wildflowers. Rain or shine, year-round, Paynes Prairie always knows how to put on a show.
This month's program is all about pollinators, some of the most important animals that we have at the prairie. Without our pollinators, many of the plants that thrive here wouldn't be able to survive. We're going to show you some of the best places in the park to find them so that when you come, you know exactly where to explore. Let's do it.
The Lachua Trail is a great place to start your prairie adventure. Located at the park's north entrance, this trail winds its way around Alachua Sink, where water from the prairie drains underground. It's a fantastic place to spot birds and alligators, and an easy hike that has both paved sections and a boardwalk. Be sure to keep an eye out for lavender tie vine flowers, a native species of morning glory that's very popular with the park's pollinators. Next up, make your way to the park's south entrance and drive along the main road until you reach the Chicala Trail. Winding through tall pines, saw palmettos, and watery marshes, the Chicala Trail's 6.5 miles are split into several different loops, allowing you to hike as much or as little as you'd like. Be on the lookout for short-leaf gay feather, sometimes called blazing stars. Pollinators love to drink the nectar from their bright purple flowers, making this a great trail to spot them as they fly from plant to plant. Once you've had your fill on the Chicala Trail, make your way down the rest of the park drive to the Prairie's Visitor Center. Just behind the building, you'll find the entrance to the last trail on our list, the Cones Dyke Trail. Tracing the edge of the park, you'll get great views of the prairie and its surrounding wetlands. But watch your step. This trail is also frequently visited by the park's horses. While you walk, try to spot Chapman's Goldenrod, whose vibrant yellow flowers are sure to attract pollinators. And when you're finished, head back to the visitor center and walk the short path to the Prairie Observation Tower. You'll get sweeping views of the prairie from the top of the 50-foot tower and a memorable end to your park adventure.
Those are just a few of the options for exploring Paynes Prairie Preserve State Park while searching for pollinators. But remember to always keep safety in mind. Here are a few tips to keep both you and wildlife safe while exploring our park. Tip 1, never get too close to a wild animal. Whether you've spotted a bee or a bison, make sure to keep your distance to keep both you and the animal safe from harm. Tip 2, always stay on the park trails. When we wander off the trail, we risk stumbling into hidden wildlife or holes, or possibly trampling sensitive plants. We all benefit when we stay on the trail. Tip 3, be prepared. Any trip to a state park is an adventure, and every adventurer needs to be prepared. Make sure to bring lots of water, a park map, and good walking shoes before you hit the trails. Tip 4, most importantly, have fun!
We hope you enjoy visiting Paynes Prairie as part of the Museum in the Parks program. There are all kinds of pollinators out there, and we want you to find them all. So good luck, have fun, and we'll see you here real soon.